Heather, how do you diagnose asthma?
Well, diagnosing asthma really starts with a very good history. So discussion between the patient and the physician is so important to know what sort of symptoms someone is experiencing, when they experience them, what sort of triggers they've noticed. Because not all cough, not all shortness of breath is asthma, but there are very important clues in the history that can make the patient and the physician really suspect it. How do you use diagnostic tests to enhance that diagnosis?
I mean, I completely agree. The history is so important. As we say in medicine, is all that wheezes is not asthma. So we have to be careful of making the right diagnosis and making sure there are not other reasons for the shortness of breath and wheezing. So I think a history and a good examination is quite important. And then, of course, I supplement that with doing a spirometry. But as you know, again, that is not necessarily abnormal in patients with asthma. And then beyond that, you know, I do like to get an x-ray, at least in my adult patients. I do get a chest x-ray because, again, there could be things that can present with shortness of breath, which may not be evident, and the chest x-ray can be useful. But it's amazing how much of it still boils down to a good history and assessing symptoms and making sure. Other diagnostic tests, do you use exhaled nitric oxide testing at all?
So many specialists taking care of asthmatics will use exhaled nitric oxide. And what this is it's actually measuring a byproduct that's released from our lungs. And changes in the level of exhaled nitric oxide can tell us about inflammation in the lungs. So it by and of itself is not a diagnostic test for asthma, but it can help in the diagnosis and it can also help in monitoring asthma to see what the inflammation looks like at that point in time.
And then I think allergy testing can be useful. In the very difficult cases where we can't be sure what's going on, then other things like methacholine challenge can be quite useful in diagnosing asthma too.
Absolutely. And in children with asthma, especially young children, we might not have some of these confirming tests. We might have to rely on a little bit more detective work because young children can't do spirometry yet. So sometimes a physician will give a parent of a young child some albuterol to try at home during time of their symptoms. And if their symptoms improve temporarily with albuterol, this can strongly suggest that asthma is the culprit.
So it's not as easy to diagnose asthma as one would like it to be, but I think with good clinical medicine, we can make the diagnosis with a fair amount of certainty mostly.